In the name of Allah, the ever merciful and the all merciful, all praise be to Allah, the Lord of the worlds and all the companions, may Allah be pleased with him. Firstly, I'm back again. We are still discussing the stories of the real heroes of the Islam. We started in the first video talking about one of the heroes of the Islam, one of the greatest men, and we're still also discussing, but today we have one of the greatest females. We have one of the greatest women. She is the daughter of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. She deserves to be called, as Allah said, Rijal. Rijal, the literary translation of it is men, but it's not a real translation of it. It has a connotation, because Rijal, it includes the women and the men. It includes the females and males. So she deserves, or those people, they deserve to be called as men. Allah said, among the believers are men who are true or sincere about what they covenant Allah to do, about what they promised Allah to do. من المؤمنين رجال رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. They were true about what they covenant Allah to do. So one of the رجال today, she is called, or one of the heroines, if I may say it. One of the heroines today, she is called Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And she is a half-sister of Aisha, from different mother, because his mother is called Kutayla bint Abd al-Uzza. Asma bint Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, she is telling a story of Mary to Zubayr ibn Awwam. Zubayr ibn Awwam of the 10 who are promised by paradise, one of those people who defended the Prophet Muhammad, trying to protect him. He is the father of the firstborn after the immigration to Al-Madinah Al-Munawwara. His son is called Abdullah ibn Zubayr ibn Awwam, who is known as, or he is well known as Hamamatul Masjid, the vision of the mosque, or the dog of the mosque. Of course, because when he stayed to pray in front of Allah, he did not care about anything else. He just concerning to his relation with Allah. So he's called the vision of the mosque. Of course, she said, I married Az-Zubayr and he had nothing. What? He had nothing? Totally, he had nothing except a horse and a camel used to carry water over it. He had nothing. And she accepted to marry him because she is learning us one of the lessons that it's not just all about how money I had, but it's about what about my personality, what about my virtues, what about my values. That's all, that's the great thing. Of course, money is important. There is no one say anything else, but you have to look for what is the most important than the other. And that's what Asma bint Abi Bakr is trying to show or learn us. So she married Zubayr ibn Awwam and she said, Zubayr ibn Awwam was so jealous. I married him and he had nothing except a horse and a camel. And I accepted to marry him. She is the daughter of the greatest man. She is the daughter of the great businessman. Of course, he was the wealthy man, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And also she accepted to marry because she is trying to make it easy to get married. She's trying to make it easy to get married for Yaf. She's trying to pave the way for others to get married. Not like out in these days. And that's what's trying to, inshallah, trying to correct it. So, she's telling us one of the stories with his husband. She is a wise wife. That's what's gonna next, inshallah. Look at this. She said that I married him and he had nothing and he was so jealous. So, the Prophet Muhammad gave him a piece of land after the immigration to Al-Madinah Munawwara, and it was 2 miles and a half far from Al-Madinah Munawwara, and she used to go there on feet. So she said, I saw the Prophet Muhammad with a group of people one day while I was coming back from this land. I saw the Prophet Muhammad with a group of people and he offered to get right behind them, and I remember the jealousy of Zubayr ibn Awwam. She's telling her husband that, I remembered your jealousy, so I refused to get right behind the Prophet Muhammad. Despite the Prophet Muhammad, she respected the feelings even the feelings of her husband. She respected, she respected the feeling of her spouse because she is also respecting the personality of her husband. I do not gonna do thing which is gonna make my husband get angry. I'm not gonna do thing piss my husband off. I'm not gonna do thing like this. This is one of the lessons that we have to pay attention to Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq after this story. She said, I remember your jealous Ashu, I refused to get right behind him. And also Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, she was well known as that who need to come shoes of two belts. The Prophet Muhammad gave us this title, as he gave her father before as-Siddiq this title, that testified the truth. She is also known by that who need to come. She is of those two belts, and mitaq, something it's called as belt. The Prophet Muhammad gave him this title during the immigration with his friend Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, which is his father. During the immigration, she was trying to prepare al-hijra to al-Madinah al-Munawwara. She was trying to prepare the provision, the food and the drink, to take it with them. But she did not find anything to tie the water skin, you know, something like a bottle. She did not find anything to tie the water skin. She took her belts off and cut it into two pieces just immediately. And it's all the ingenuity. It illuminates the ingenuity of Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq. So that's why the Prophet Muhammad gave us this title, that you need to qayyim. She took her belts off and she tied the water skin by it, and later on the Prophet Muhammad called her by that niqaqi, Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, the daughter of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And finally, Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, she proves and she illuminates one of the basic things in Islam, the relation of Muslim with others. I mean the relation of Muslim with un-Muslim. What should I do? That's what Asma bint Abi Bakr as-Siddiq clarified in hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. She said, my mother came to me, you know, her mother's called Qutaylah, and she was a mushrika. My mother came to me and she was a mushrika, she was a pagan, she was a Muslim. My mother came to me. So she went to the Prophet Muhammad seeking to his verdict about that. What should I do? My mother came to me and she desires to get or to receive a word from me. Shall I keep good relation with her? The Prophet Muhammad said immediately, yes, keep good relation with her. Keep good relation with her mother. The Prophet Muhammad didn't tell her to do not talk to your mother or something like that, but he told her, okay, keep good relation with your mother. Even she is a mushrika, yes, of course, even if she was a mushrika, keep good relation with your mother. Course, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Mumtahina, Allah does not forbid you from those Muslims or from those people who do not get you from your homes or expel you from your homes, or from those people who do not fight you in religion, to be or to act kindly with them, to act kindly with them and be upright during your relation and to be upright with them. لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين. Allah loves this who are upright while you are dealing with others. I hope you get a benefit from this, inshallah. And I hope you learned something. And if you have a notice, as we said in the previous video, you can leave it below this video, inshallah. And I'm going to pay attention and try to make up the next video, inshallah. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.